Hey everyone, ArchTalko here, welcome you back to Xenoblade Chronicles. In the previous episode, we did some side quest stuff, I think, and this episode we're probably going to be doing some more Xenoblade stuff. I mean, that's probably going to happen. Also, I meant to say more side quest stuff, probably. I mean, that's kind of been the trend. You see that exclamation point in the thumbnail, you know what's going on, because Lord knows I don't. So we do have some change equipment, but more importantly, we have a Jan. He's going to be kicking things off today, and got some pretty interesting stuff in store. Ooh, that's rough, buddy. Poor Jan got cucked. Okay, I'm saying it ironically. I know it's not really a proper use of it, and it's really a dumb word to be used as an insult. You know what? If you're watching this and you're into cucking, all the power to you. You embrace it. Maybe not, like, around me, per se, but be your own man. Or get your own man to be your... Oh, anyway, so Jan was saved by a colony defense girl, and you know, I mean, this starts off pretty insane. You know, she's trying to cook him dinner to show thanks, but she went all shy. Jan, I'm sure you do. I'm sure we all do. Wonder what Minnie would like. So there's our big tip off right there. Jan, the old coot's getting the hots for a gal. Natter on Jan. Oh my Britain. What are you natter on? Is that really a it's, you know, I love it. I'm stealing that from all y'all in the UK. Anyway though, so Minnie, I can't remember if we've even talked to her before, but it's been so long since we last eyes. Kenny, my boy, how fare thee? Okay. He's... It was me the whole time. Or maybe his fan club hiding out in the bushes. Guys, we've gone over this. He's mine. Get out of here, man. Get out of here. Okay, sorry. Getting distracted. But Kenny got Rohan. It's been far too long since I've said that. So I can't remember if we've even talked to Minnie, but let's give Jan the benefit of the doubt. Maybe we can see if the feelings are mutual at all. And I think she shows up at nighttime, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, there she is. Okay, so Minnie. I mean, you don't look super young, so... Interesting. I wonder if she's talking about Sesame and the crew. You're not, really, that wasn't really what I was thinking you were gonna say, though. Hold up. Hey! Oh, that's funny. I think that's actually a hint to get the achievement for talking to all the defense force soldiers to get that one, defense force achieve. Oh, there it is. Okay. Hey, all the power to you, Minnie. Anything else, though? Ooh. Oh, Minnie, it might not be a trap. So, okay. You know, she did it as thanks. I'm not quite feeling that reciprocal love. I mean, it doesn't really help that Minnie is actually 22. Or no, maybe she's 23. Either way, she's like literally my age. So, yeah, I don't know. I'm not quite feeling it. Dionysus, what do you have to say for your other fellow old coot? Yeah, 23 to be exact. Okay, so in order to activate a certain quest, we need to talk to Dionysus, and well, first those two, in order to get this going. If you answer he's too old for that girl, that's what will continue, that will allow you to do the quest. If you answer love keeps the ticker going, you will lock yourself out of doing this quest for this playthrough. I mean, love is love, but honestly speaking, I think he's a little too old for that girl. Like, I'm friends with a coworker who's dating someone who's like 15 years older than her, and that's like still a little weird, but it still works because he looks pretty young and acts pretty young too. But that like 40-year gap, that's a little too much. He should know better at that age. Such an old fool. So, yeah. I'm glad we had that little heart-to-heart. And little known fact, Dionysus can actually move at the speed of light. Yeah, 74. Jan. Okay, yeah. Jan is 66. She is 23. Okay, I was right about that. That is literally a 43-year-old gap. That is almost as old as my parents. Okay. He's old enough to be that grandpa, so I think we need to put a stop to this. So yeah, little known fact, Dionysus already talked to Jan in the time it took for us to get here. He can actually move at the speed of light. I'm sorry, Lightspeed Sonnen, but you were basically obsolete from the moment you were born, because the Lord knows you ain't got nothing on Dionysus. Because as we all know, we must all make a wish to Dionysus. Anyway. So, okay. I love that line. It's so good for an old boy like you to be chasing girls around.
So you're speaking your mind as usual, Reyn. But if you feel the same way, then that makes things simpler.
Okay. And so then we get into this. I don't understand this quest. This whole quest is like leading up to the whole concept of like really old people trying to date younger people and just kind of the weird moral gray zone that brings up. But then out of nowhere, it does a 180 and we end up just having to fight a unique monster to end this quest. And it's like, so you want us to go all the way to Mechon Forest so that we don't turn out like old horn dogs like you? I don't get it. But anyway, we need to fight Elder Gragas, which is going to be over by the Napon Arch. So bam. So if you're like me, you've probably already fought Elder Gragas at least once, and if he's not appearing in the spot, don't worry, all you have to do is keep reloading this area because he'll only have a 30% chance of spawning after being defeated. And like that, we are done, because yeah, again, we've already fought him once, I've already shown that whole fight, so why show it again? I'll sing I, good to have, I suppose, and with that, I guess with our character built up, question mark, let's go to Jan.
Oh, you know who this is, you big tease.
Impressive. Looks like I heard you all wrong. It doesn't look like I need to test you anymore. I'll find some other layabout kids to turn to responsible adults.
Well, that's that. Question mark again. Well, good to know. We got somebody to pound in that character. I don't understand this quest. I feel like it could have had a way better, I don't know, output than what that ended up being, but hey, I mean, it's still kind of interesting. Also, definitely a very like awkward quest to do your first time through, because you really have to know and you really have to be talking to these NPCs like at all times in order to get it going. But hey, with Jan all straightened out, good to go, and not hitting on any young gals, we're gonna be basically doing the miscellaneous stuff this episode, starting Colony 9, working our way up in the next areas that we unlocked throughout the course of our adventure, although I do actually need to activate someone in Frontier Village. And that's someone's Pachipa. Ah, what a cutie. I love her so much. I love all the Napon kids in Frontier Village. Ah, they're all wonderful. Wonderful, I say.
Legend says Dadapon's our mythical empress. catch him, gotta catch him all. Gotta catch him all. Deadly spiders. I told Piki and Kiriku about Dadapon's the empress. But Piki and Kiriku say no such thing as empress. They say just fairy tale. Dadapon would never lie to Pachipa. Friends, catch empress so everyone believe Pachipa.
Okay. But Piki, you of all people should not be like discrediting ancient myths and stuff that your friends believe in. Because the Lord knows you got enough experience with the other naysayers. Going to you. Freaking kids, man. Can't live with them. Can't live without them. Also, that was the most adorable line. Oh my god. Melly, give that boy a hug. Give that Minon boy a big ol' hug. Shulk! What are you doing? Oh no! He's dead! He's Brech! Dude, okay, look. I'm just as excited as the next guy for that Xenoblade 2 footage, but boy, you gotta contain yourself. Gotta stop making love to that fence. This is amazing.
Oh my god. Can I sink the land? My strength is failing. Well. That's a new one. God, it's about time! How many episodes has it taken me to actually show that off? Because if you do hit the proper spot where the stairs go underwater, then it gets the whole animation with you falling into a deep pit of water, and then it saves you like a couple seconds when you fall down from that pit. Anyway, now that I'm talking to Pachipa, let's talk to the other Napon clan. So, yeah? Aw. So, you know, kind of just being another dog. Pipiki. I get it. I know he's acting like another stupid adult, but he just has the best interests for you in mind. You know, he just wants the best for this village, so don't be so hard on him. Okay, Bana's doing his best. Ooh, little Napon kid love triangle. Oh, it's so cute. She has a crush on Pipiki, but Pipiki has a crush on Pachipa. Oh my god. Oh, these kids. I just want to pinch all their cheeks. God, oh. Riki, look. Been there, done that, honey. I'm on your side. Just like Charla's on Melia's side. foreshadowing. Anyway, with these guys taken care of. Oh, look at the boing boings. Also, Rasha, I see your quest there. We're not going to do you yet, but we will soon. Choice of words. Oh.
Pachipa will have proof that Mythical Empress is real? Mythical Empress is real. Why village littlepon not believe? She in Windy Cave. Jumped down big hole near Zack's guy post to go. But Mythical Empress is legend. Proof very difficult to find. Garugano, if you bash Arachno a nest, you can get her ornament. That should be all proof Pachipa need. And like he says, if we actually pull up the map real quick.
This is really cool. I love this. So normally, if we were to go to Windy Cave, there'd be a little section that we normally wouldn't have access to because the ledge would be too high. You can even kind of see it dividing there. But if we go over to the more round part and go directly above, you'll see a hole directly above there. And if you go to said hole, it will actually lead to that area, and it's so cool because there's no prompts or anything that leads to this. It's solely on you to observe the map and make your way based off of that. It's just, it's so cool. Now, Daughter Empress isn't a unique monster, so it can be easy to kind of overlook her, but not a very difficult monster, so given that big old boink boink. And with that, we get the Empress ornament. Very nice. So I don't think we get anything cool. Nah, not really cool. So let's go ahead and actually, you know what? First off, has their description? That wasn't English, I don't think. But has their description never was? And honestly, like with that, that's basically everything that I need to say or ever will need to ever say. So you know, that's pretty cool. I forgot these guys were in here, let's just go ahead and warp out. You better be forking over some serious though after that, I'm just saying.
Wait one second, friends, where's Mythical Empress? Is Empress so small Pachipa cannot see her? Oh, so friends didn't see Empress with their own eyes. Oh, too bad. What? Friends found Empress ornaments? That must mean Empress exists! Datapon wasn't lying!
I hope I was of some help.
You couldn't have been more help. Come on, Melia, be proud of yourself, girl! Be proud, you say. You are correct, Charla. I am proud of the job I did. Must tell Kurikyu and Pipiki!
I almost totally butchered their names, but with that, it's like Napon Sage all over again. Proved all them naysayers wrong. So, we did some good. I'm so happy. Boost that little thing, self-esteem and all that fun stuff. So, with that, we're gonna go...
Shulk, I see you eyeing that fence, my boy.
Oh, man. So frisky, man. Just going in for all the seconds. Anyway, though, it's shortcut time. Because our business here in Frontier Village is close to being done, but not quite yet. There is one last thing I want to do. It's pretty important, okay? It's none other than this heart-to-heart. It has been taunting us for far too long. So you'll never guess who it's going to be between. Interesting. Well, the heart-to-heart itself is none other than at the Pollen Works. So, post me wanting to interject real quick, like, I forgot to mention that the annotations are kind of no longer a thing on YouTube, which sucks because most of this Let's Play was kind of centered around the annotations, so, for now, I'm just going to be including the timestamps to the different dialogue options right next to each option, and I guess the countdown will just go in center of the screen. If you have any ideas for better alternatives to this, definitely let me know. For now, at least these next couple episodes, this is just what I'm going to be doing. But yeah, definitely suggest any ideas that you may or may not have. So anyway, back to the episode.
Achoo! For Tude Village's famous Pollen Works!
Wow, Riki! Great machine! Is it all made from wood?
Don't say wrong word! This not machine! Mechon? What about Mechon? No Mechon in Village!
The Mechon are evil machines. I thought that might be the reason.
Riki is Hiropan. Mechon not scary to Hiropan.
Okay, my mistake. I guess nothing scares Hiropan Riki, huh?
Is Chulk scared of Mechon? Chulk scared? Well, Riki thinks Chulk not afraid because Chulk has monado. Riki have big fear. Oka. Oka scariest in whole world.
I know how you feel. When Fiora gets angry, I duck for cover.
Fiora, no, Chulk, don't become sad boy. No, Chulk. Hello, Chulk. Eyes of Chulk get watery. Why?
I'm okay. It's fine. Not crying.
I'm crying. Chulk knows strong hum hum, but Riki knows Chulk's still young boy, really. If Chulk want to cry, Riki lend Chulk his fur. Chulk cry boohoo lots and lots.
Your fur? Thanks, Riki. I guess. So if I feel sad, we can hug it out, right?
A real hum hum hug. No, Chulk. No hug and cuddle. Cuddle for Melly only. Melly special. Riki not cuddle with guys. Riki ain't into that gay shit.
Aw, oh, no fair. I wanna know how soft and cuddly your fur really is. Oh my god, and already we're getting glimpses into Riki being like, it's a man's huge dad of the group, but Riki is there to just comfort everyone in his own Riki way. I love him so much. I love these two so much. So, you guys know the drill. Bada boom, bada bing. See you either way.
It's not so much that I'm scared. Wow, Chulk really brave. Riki's friends really brave. Riki proud. Everyone should be Hiropan.
I just can't forget what happened to Fiora. And it's all the Mechon's fault.
Hello, hello, Chulk. Riki being nice, so listen to Riki. Ooh, is Chulk angry?
What? Oh, sorry, Riki, I'm not angry at you. Listen, you're the bravest, toughest Hiropan I've ever known.
Chulk really think Riki brave? Oh, Chulk right, Riki is brave. Hiropan! Hiropan! Hiropan!
Yes, Riki, calm down. But you know what? I really will need you out there.
Riki to the rescue! Count on Riki, Chulk!
Man, okay, and it should be worth noting, right? Like, Chulk definitely is kind of the sort of reserved, nerdy type, but at his core, he does kind of have a lot of anger built up into him, and he really just breaks that trope. So, I don't know. I really enjoy it. Either way, though, you guys know the drill.
Yay, yay! Chulk, right? Machine has metal. Not on device, use no metal. So, not call machine.
Riki, that's not how that works, actually. It's like a lever or it has a pulley. It's kind of classified as a machine. Anyway,
Riki Napan alone enforced. If forced not to have metal, Napan not to use metal. Long, long time ago, Napan make many, many things.
I'm impressed.
I'd love to know more about these pollen orbs, too. They light up and produce heat, but they never burn up. Yellow and blue orbs are safe to eat. But the red one, ooh, not so safe.
I saw a red one by the lift. It looked tasty enough.
Ooh, Chulk want to eat the red one?
Oh, Riki not like red ones. Riki's stomach go thump thump and squeal squeal. If Shulk eat and finish whole red one, Riki give Shulk medal.
Sounds like a challenge to me.
Riki no need red orb anyway. Oka make yummy food for Riki.
Is that what makes you so bouncy? Maybe I need to eat more orbs. Oh man, Lord Shulk, the last thing you need is more boing boing, young man. We've seen enough of that from you today. Either way though, let's go ahead. Yeah, the things.
Ooh, Shulk too clever for Riki. Too much of big brain hum hum.
I've seen a lot of Magma Forest. Some of these parts don't really look like they came from here.
Metal is held together with very strong rope given by bad people. And Hom Hom teaches use oil to make motion smooth. Device go round and round with only small amounts of energy.
That's fascinating, the way all the different techniques fit together.
Nopon live all over Bionis, here, there, everywhere. Nopon see new things, bring new things back to village.
I love it, it's a great design. Mixing foreign and Nopon technology? It's brilliant, and a lot like our party makeup. I'm really impressed, Riki.
Riki not to make it, but thank you.
No, man, dude, that's your moment of truth to, like, shine and put it together. But yeah, I don't know. I almost feel like that section's kind of like an allegory to the own brilliance of our own party makeup, the way that we have all these different races and people coming together for a greater purpose. I don't know. I love this heart to heart. Lots of great options. Definitely recommend exploring all of them. But with all that taken care of, we are now moving on to Eryth Sea. So right now I'm over here at Hovering Reef 5. I want to apologize. I kind of goofed during those Eryth Sea episodes where we're doing mostly Eryth Sea side quests because we kind of still have a bunch of challenge quests and stuff to take care of before we actually move on to Valak Mountain. And you may remember this is actually very familiar. This is the part where I thought there was a unique monster that only appeared during the, I think it was the Shooting Stars. That I kept dying as dumb man over and over again before really realizing the error of my ways. It turns out there actually is a unique monster that we need for a specific challenge quest. Where's my Flabbergasted Jerome? That's the boy. He's a little far away, so I guess we'll try maybe this side of this island. Which, by the way, I really, really love these islands and the way that sometimes you have to like drop down to the center of them to access like a different layer of them. I don't know. Eryth Sea, for as kind of samey as a lot of these islands have, a lot of them do provide a lot of really, like, unique vistas and stuff. So, I don't know. I can really appreciate it. Hovering Reef 5 is pretty cool. When you don't die over and over again, trying to drop down into it. God, I can really... Oh, there we go. Okay. Okay, here we go. So, man, I don't even know what to talk about. Actually... Oh my god, that was brilliant. That was amazingly insane. Also, Shulk, what are you doing as soon as you're on the job? Can't believe this boy. Just causing problems left and right. Transcending reality. For shame. Okay, speaking of Shulk, I have another complaint with Xenoblade. And it's specifically that, honestly guys, Shulk is my least favorite person to play as. I legitimately enjoy playing as Sharla more than Shulk. Once, you know, Sharla gets, like, a full art palette. Because before that, I guess she is a little bit boring. But still, like, the problem with Shulk is that he only gets access to 8 main arts throughout the entire game. With, obviously, the addition of the other 8 monado arts that are way more situational and you obviously have way less access to because using one negates the access to all of the other ones. And, I don't know, because of that, Shulk is just very, very flowcharty. And no matter how many times you play through the game, you really can't build him any better, if that makes sense. Like, I don't know. I mean, Shulk is arguably one of the most versatile and useful party members in the game. I mean, he's the one that single-handedly has access to the monado arts, so there's a lot that he can deal with that a lot of the other party members just straight up can't. But that doesn't really take away from the fact that I just don't really enjoy playing as Shulk, and that's kind of the reason why I've been neglecting him for a lot of this Let's Play, because many hours as I put into this game, I'm just tired of playing as Shulk. So, anyway, end rant. And he's not really that bad to play as, but he still is my least favorite character to play as. So, anyway, I have to hunt this Rakti Lexos, and he is, like,
really not wanting to play, is he?
Come on! Come on! Ooh, that felt good. Ooh, that felt good. Honey.
So anyway, yeah, comment down below, who is your least favorite party member to play as? I'm curious. We still have a little bit more hunting to do. I need to fight one of these bad boys. So if you will let me fight him, that would be fantastic. There we go. And that was a beauty. God, oh, this like transition period between the sunset and the nighttime, it is, oh, it's so gorgeous, especially with like Eryth Sea. I don't know, that purplish pinkish hue is just, oh, it goes so nicely with this place. We're not done yet though. If you're wanting a little more convenient area to fight Rakulexos, you can actually come over here to the Saltnar Seal Island and bada boom bada bing. Okay, now moment of truth. Can I get my booty? Like either way, I'm gonna get one of them that I, I could just get both. Thank you, Xenoblade Chronicles. Oh my gosh, best game for the Nintendo Wii 2010, all rights reserved. Oh my goodness. That was so nice. That was, wow. Wow, what an upstanding young man. That is to say, Xenoblade Chronicles, not Dunban, although he is also very upstanding. Don't quite know how much of a like young man character he fits. Although, I mean, he's definitely no Dixon. That's for sure. Either way, though, you may notice that that little ether deposit thing slash heart-to-heart place has remained unexplored. Until now! Aha, my boy. It's actually right down there. So let's go ahead and make our way there. That's so gorgeous. God, this game's so pretty. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and meet you guys over by that island. Now, when we make our way closer, you're gonna notice some not quite so friendly faces. I can words once in a while. But yes, yeah, Sleeping Dragon Isle. This is a really interesting location, to say the least. It is swarming with enemies that really are not the greatest Shulk & Co. Fan club members, to say the least. Kind of like in the high 80s. So, we do have a water ether crystal deposit, and I've kind of been neglecting getting the ether crystals, like, and I really shouldn't. I really need to go out of my way more to get those because they do really, really make things a lot easier. So, yeah, with that though, we're going to kind of just hug this rock because Lord knows we are not about that Sardi life, or whatever those actually are called. I think they're Sardis. Not totally sure though. But if we make our way over to the opposite side of the island, I may have just taken the long way around. Oh, hey. Oh, there's another Rakulexos. Huh. Actually, didn't realize there was another one hanging out. Not the most efficient way to farm for them, but I guess, you know, if you still need one, he's right there. There's also a... Come on, select him. Carbon Tude! Oh! You want to talk about an S-tier name, and also some S-tier sounds, like, just listen to this boy. God, there's like something really unnerving about the sound effects this nice hard spiny boy emits. That I love him so much. He's also sound based, so you do have to kind of melee your way around him, or you will definitely face kind of imminent death, just sort of kind of immediate death. Ah, his name though, Carbon Tude. Oh, that's got to be like somehow in this video's title. It's got to be. God, and he's so cute. Oh my god, he's so cute. He's a cutie. He's like a little Sonic. Anyway, we have a heart to heart. That's why we're over here. I can't get over him though. I love Carbon Tude. Anyway.
Oi, Riki, what you up to?
Sorry.
Reyn, see? Lots of fish. Fish with wings jump out of water. See?
You must be joking. There's no such thing as fish with wings.
You've lost the plot. He's so British.
See? Fish fly!
Oh yeah, I saw that. So, fish can really fly?
Riki not see before either. A village and forest not have flying fish.
Right then, only one thing for it. We catch one and eat it. Of course.
What? We ain't allowed or something? Frying fish special. It's sacred. Riki eat fish then be cursed.
Just looks like any old fish. I reckon it'll taste great.
Riki no understand. Riki see Riki has wings, no? Creatures with wings are special.
Oh, that is true. Alright, I getcha. So it's like eating your own kind.
Gross, Riki, but yes.
Sorry, man. Didn't mean to scare. It's alright, though. We've got loads of tasty fish back home.
Riki, Riki hungry now. Oh, come on, then. I'll take you.
We'll have to get my fish and stuff. Whoever catches the most fish wins.
You're on, Riki. Riki good at fishing.
Oh my god, these guys are so adorable. I love them so much. So, okay. No, cover two, no! Okay, so anyway, if you want to go ahead and see the alarm, just go ahead and hit reset or continue on to the rest of the video. Oh god, please, no, have a family.
Oh yeah, my time has come. I'll show all of my honest my fishing skills. Ah, no.
What's the matter with you?
Riki, you remember that creature with wings are special to Napan? If Riki eats flying fish, Riki gets in trouble.
Don't worry about it. No one's looking.
No, no, no. Dugga will get mad. Oh, but Ricky's stomach make noise.
I won't tell anyone. But that means you gotta fish twice as hard as me.
Riki not happy, but food is most important to Riki. Riki get all fish before Riki.
I knew it. When food's around, you're suddenly up for it. He's so cute. Okay, so I'm gonna be honest with you guys. This doesn't have like the most significant backstory or really character building, but god dang, if Riki and Riki together aren't the just best duo. God, I love these beautiful soft boys. So anyway, you know the drill. I will see you either way. Oh yeah, baby.
Riki has lost his plot. Riki, silly hum hum.
Calm down, Riki. Don't get so defensive.
Riki not feel nice when Riki make fun of Riki.
Looking at the water again, I can see something like that.
See? Riki told Riki truth. Eryth Sea has lots and lots of strange fish swimming.
They even got hovering rocks in this place. I'll believe anything.
Riki want to visit many other strange places. See all of Bionis. Riki and friends can see lots and lots of strange creatures together.
Sounds like a plan, Riki. And just think of all the food to eat.
Oh, Ryan's eyes bigger than his great big fat stomach.
Hey, take a look at yourself, lardball. Ho ho! Got him!
Riki want to finish fighting and go traveling with Riki as friends.
Friends, huh? I'll think about that one. And, you know, Riki's just casually flying with his wings, no less. But I wouldn't mind seeing a bit of Bionis either. So, I guess this does bring up a really interesting point, that those giant arm-like appendages that the Napan used as, like, well, arms, are actually wings. So it makes me wonder, Riki, back with the whole button fiasco situation with the high NT tomb, why couldn't you have just, like, hovered back over the pit? How does it even work? I mean, I feel like they're bumblebees, right? How do the physics even work with these guys? How on Bionis are you 40? That means you're like an old man.
Riki not old man. Napan and Hum Hum different.
But the Napan I met at Colony 9 acted their age. Why not you?
Riki should act his age. 5. Riki a big baby like littlepon.
Why you little? I'm gonna... I give up. What's the point?
Riki ordered the Riki, so Riki should respect Riki.
Okay, old man. I'll give it a go. You haven't got long left anyway. Oh, these two are like the best.
Can't sit it.
Really? Oh my god. Okay, well, anyway. Riki,
best duo, best lovers. I love them to death, almost as much as they love each other, which is not to say much, even though I love them dearly. Anyway, things. Bye.
Yeah, you better get out of here. Yeah, you little rascal, you little turd bucket.
You two didn't see anything, right?
So, next up, we do have one, and I repeat, only one collection quest left to do.
And I'm too lazy to go around Eryth Sea just collecting all those good old item orbs, so we're gonna go to our gal area, which I don't think we've actually talked to before, and get ourselves a Doomsday Poppy. This is what we need. We actually need 5 of them, I think?
Okay, I did not mean to skip through that text. My bad, but yeah, that was for collection quest 1.
Got sturdy armor, because why not? And I'm actually gonna go ahead, I'm gonna trade with her one more time, because that did take away all my Doomsday Poppies, and I will need at least one for that good old Collectopedia. So, I have to burp very bad. That was a nice one. No sturdy armor, I will put it in my body. So, awesome. Guys, we are so close to being done. I think we only have one more quest that I want to take care of, and then we are set. So we're actually going to be making our way back here to the pod landing site. Come on. If we go the opposite direction, back to this side of the bridge, and I think, did I show this off when we were first making our way to Valk Mountain? Honestly, can't remember now that I think about it. Also, I think I want to build up some affinity with Dumban and Reyn. I think, either way though, turns out the bridge that's connecting this part of Mechon Forest to the other side that we were traversing across for lord knows how many episodes, it's actually busted. There's no way for us to actually go across there. I mean, there is, but just, you know, kind of plumbing straight down to our death. So if we talk to the Xenoblade researcher, we might just find a workaround for this. So boy, what do you got to say?
Help! Someone help! Don't just look! Help! Bridge broken! It's so inconvenient!
How worrying.
A problem indeed. I don't know what to do! If we no fix bridge, it big problem for Napon to get back to village.
It is inconvenient. If the Hyantia hadn't brought us, we couldn't have got here. What a pain.
Yeah, it's horrible, but it's fate that you here.
You might be right. I mean, after all, we are notorious for doing literally everyone's legwork.
You must grab materials to fix bridge. Need hoed planks and rogal axe crests.
I don't know what axe crests could do, but the hoed planks actually do kind of make sense. Well, actually, if it's an axe crest, maybe they're used to, like, chop down the wood to make it into, like, sizable planks for the bridge. Although, if they're planks, I feel like they would kind of already come in, like, bridge-sized pieces. I feel like I'm looking way too much into this. Anyway, we have the axe crests, we still need the planks, and also, if I take the camera back, you can actually see the bridge is here, just kinda a little flaccid. A little flaccid, if you will. It's the opposite problem I have whenever I see Kenny God Brohan. Anyway, if we talk to this Napon researcher. So, Lupa's kinda the head of these guys, and it goes full circle because... Well, okay, actually, I want to talk to Tuzu. I kind of forgot that you existed, Tuzu. I'm very sorry, but she is the wifey pawn of our good old friend Garugu. So, and she's but cheap as mommy pawn, and ugh. I love that family to death, man. Good old Tuzu.
Oh, fine.
Hey, you know what? No problem. The more we can help you guys out, the better. Of course, Dunban is just hitting off with all the Napon children. You know. The Dunban is like a hit with the kids. He's an all natural when it comes to interacting with the kids. You know that for a fact. But it comes full circle because Lupa, wait for it, is holding the hold planks. Oh, look at that. It's poetic, really. Xenoblade Chronicles, 2010 for the Nintendo Wii. One word, poetic. Really? I need 5? Okay. No, it's cool. I only wasted like 70 minutes trading. Let's go back to the boys.
Got all materials? Wow, you collected all so quick.
I fix bridge right now. Wait for me.
It turns out, even though Lupa's heading the research, he actually graduated with a master's from the Juju School of Transmogrifying All the Poop. Because, yeah, he took like 5 planks of wood, 3 axes, and just made an entire bridge over this chasm using them. So, I mean, all the kudos to him. You know, he's basically the greatest alchemist that was ever a guy to guy. And doing this quest, it might not seem super important because we can't just fast travel here, but this is actually a prerequisite for a very, very important side quest chain a little bit later on, so I highly recommend you do this. I also recommend you actually go on the bridge itself because, as you just saw right there, it is counted as a location that you get some bonus experience for. So, pretty cool, and also a gorgeous view. This chasm in Mechon Forest is... it's so cool. It is so cool. Especially now that we can see all the bridges in the distance. God. Have I mentioned... No, I don't think I have. Xenoblade Chronicles. It's a pretty good game. It's pretty good. But guys, with all that taken care of, we're going to go ahead. We're going to skim through all of our quest log. We have successfully done every single side quest that I have wanted to take care of at this point in the game. We do still have quite a few that are available to us, but for very specific reasons, I'm not taking them on for reasons. But we do have a couple that are still in the works that we will need just, you know, various resources from Valak Mountain to actually complete. So I figured it'd be a little efficient to at least take care of them while we're going to explore there. In addition to all that good stuff, we are doing really good on Affinity. Everyone has at least a green link with one another. Riki still needs a little bit of development, but either way, we're doing great. I feel like we're pretty well balanced. I mean, Chulk's kind of hogging a lot of it, but I mean, what can you do? I'm not going to go over like super in depth on what we're looking like with skill trees, but I can at least kind of give a nice little overview. I'm super stoked that we at least unlocked Melly's 4th skill tree, so... definitely a plus on that front. I have been leveling up arts off screen. I haven't really been showing this a whole lot, so I'll just, again, kind of give you guys a quick overview of how I've been allocating these points. I also haven't really been buying a whole lot of art books for these guys, but it's okay. We're kind of overleveled anyway, so it doesn't make a huge difference. If you are playing the game and not doing every side quest, it can be in your best interest to actually buy art books as you're playing through and really, really leveling up specific arts that you're putting a lot of time into. But we're doing fine. We are doing more than fine, actually. So anyway, guys, that's going to be it for today. Thank you all so much for watching me play, because with Valak Mountain off the distance, it is about time that we've gotten those answers that we have so desperately craved for, like, several months now for to give. See you then!